we're going to see new insight, new understanding, and new knowledge. And we're going to have some principles, even as a teenager, we're going to develop some principles that will stay with you for the rest of your life. One of the, as John chapter 9, one of the principles that have stayed with me for throughout my young life, and even now, is where there's no vision, people perish. And that has just, I heard that as a teenager, probably, or at least when I really received it. And that has just been a part of my life for a long time. And so I pray that there are some principles here today that will just be a huge impact in your life. There are some promises that God has for you. There are some promises that God has for me. And faith is the key ingredient to unlock those promises. But what we find is that oftentimes we do not know how to operate and how to activate our faith in the earth. And I think this particular lesson gives us some real good insight on how to activate our faith in the earth. The promises are already there. Now, we may be at step one where we're unaware of the promises of God. And that may just be where we'll be right now. We just don't know and we don't understand, we don't comprehend the promises and the things of God. Well, we're going to deal with that a little bit. But for many of us, we understand the promises of God. We understand that there's goodness that comes with God, that there's salvation that comes with God, that there's peace that comes with God, there's healing that comes with God, there's more than enough that comes with God. And so we understand the promises. And this is how we go a little bit deeper, and we understand the promise in the context of our personal assignments in earth. But why can't we unlock the fruit of the promise? Why can't we unlock the manifestation of the promise? Why can we not walk in the goodness and in the satisfaction and in the peace and the prosperity that God has for us? What is it that's going on? And so I believe that it's a matter of not understanding how to activate our faith in earth. And so all this year, we're going to really deal with this subject of how to activate my faith, your faith, our faith in the earth. So we're going to look at John chapter 9. We're going to look at verses 6 and 7. We're in the second part of a four-part series. And I think there's some real good words here. Listen to what it says here. Having said these things, now that's Jesus. You know, that's the conversation with Jesus and the disciples. And now, it doesn't have anything to do with man. Doesn't have anything to do with man now. Verse 6. Having said these things, the man hadn't said anything. Doesn't have anything to do with the blind man. Where do we hear the blind man speak? All we hear from verse 1 through 5 is a conversation about the blind man. We see in verse 1 that Jesus saw the blind man. And then we hear that there was a great discourse with he and his disciples about the blind man. And so it says, having said these things. So really, what did God say about you? What is God communicating about you? Let me just read the verse a little bit. He spit on the ground. Now, he there is not a man. This is Jesus again. He stood on the ground and made mud with the saliva. Then he anointed the man's eyes with mud. Well, I know the man won't speak himself, I believe. And said to him, go wash in the pool of Siloam, which means sin. So he went and washed and came back sin. And so we're going to look at this a little bit, and we're going to talk about the importance of corresponding action in the area of your faith. Corresponding action in the area of your faith. That's how we speak. That's how we communicate with the corresponding action in our faith. And that's a very important principle that I want you to really get throughout this message is, I want you to ask yourself, am I doing all that God has asked me to do? Am I doing all that God has required of me in this particular situation? If someone was looking at me, and they was looking at my body language, and they watched you for a 24-hour period, and you said you were believing God for a particular thing, what would your behavior be? Would your behavior and your actions and your movements be conducive to, that looks like someone who's waiting on the Lord. That looks like someone who's believing God for the promises to be manifested in their lives. Or does it look like someone who doesn't even know God? So the corresponding action is very, very important. So let's go back and let's look a little bit closer. So go back to 6. It says, having said these things, come. So it's the comma there. So we're going to pause. So I want you to know that there's some powerful that your revelation and your insight comes greatly from the context of the communication of Jesus Christ. It comes from the Word of God. It may not feel like it's true, but it's true. It may not feel like something is going on, but you want to be in an environment where you can hear the things of God. You want to be in an environment, home, you want to create a lifestyle, not just come here on Sunday or Tuesday or Thursday, but you want a lifestyle where you are pondering the things of God. Last night, I didn't do a whole lot of studying in the late night hour, but I just grappled with what was going on with you. I just want to know, what's going on? I didn't sleep really well. I woke up a couple of times an hour, in the hour, and I just woke up just kind of moving funny. Because I'm just grappling. Because I know you're talking. And I know you're saying something here. And it's in the presence of you talking and you saying something, that's something big. But let's go to Romans chapter, just a few books over. Romans chapter 10. And I want you to see the promise without a principle. Romans chapter 10. And this is the chapter on faith. And salvation, really. When you look at it, we'll get time. Especially 10:9. But let's look at 13. It talks about the promise. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Now that's a promise. Chapter 10, verse 13. It says, for everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. Now that's an amazing promise. That's an amazing promise that God has for us. An amazing promise. And he gives us those kind of problems. An amazing promise. Amazing. But the Bible goes on. We're going to read it a bit further. It says everybody doesn't have the opportunity to tap into this promise. But this is the promise for everybody. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. But funny thing. Look at verse 14. And we'll read it a little bit. It says, how then can they call on him in whom they have not believed? He said, well, you have to have belief to call on the name of the Lord. That is the promise, but you have to be able to operate in the principle of belief to tap into this promise. The promise is the promise, and it's the promise for you. But if you don't have belief, faith, you cannot tap into this promise. And then it says, well, how are they to believe in him of whom they never heard? It says, now, for you to develop some belief, you have to have some word in your mind. You can't call upon him that you don't know about, you haven't heard about it. So you have to have some word in your life. You have to have some instruction in your life. Preaching is really, really good. And preaching is for inspiration. It is to inspire you. It is to make you feel like you can run through that wall. So preaching is really, really good. But teaching is for instruction. And I think we're in a season as City Faith Church. We're in a season in our lives. We didn't have a whole lot of good preaching, especially from Mississippi. You've had a whole lot of good preaching in Mississippi. We have good preaching in Mississippi. But it's time for some teaching, for some instruction. So, you've told me about the promise. You've preached the promise to me. And I really believe the promise has been preached throughout my life. But now I need some instructions on how to tap into the promise. That makes sense. And so, the Bible right here says you need some word. Because I want you to have some belief, but you can't have some belief if you don't have a foundation for your belief. And the foundation comes from word. Yet watch this. Listen, and how are we to hear without someone preaching? So that is very important to make sure that, and I thank you for gathering and consistently gathering here, but it's very important for you to have a pastor in your life. It's very important. This is a principle. If the Lord take me home tomorrow, the principle still is true. If you move back to California, if you move over to New York City, it's very important to have a spiritual caregiver, a teaching pastor in your life. Now, if you don't know the promises of God, and you're not sure God exists, maybe you need a preaching pastor. Let somebody encourage you that God is real and give you some inspiration. But we transition from inspiration, we'll look at this in a minute, into instruction. And now when we come out of preaching setting, and preaching environments of inspiration. We want to be entertained, we want to be encouraged, we want to be excited, we want to be all of that. But then we come in here happy and we go home broke. We come in here happy and then in the middle of the week we can't figure out how to manipulate on the bills and how to pay the bills. And so we're stressed out all week long, but we come back on Sunday to get happy. So I think if we can tap into instruction through the Word of God, we're going to see something amazing happen. And so it's very important to have someone preaching the Word in your life. And it's fine to attend other churches and gather with other churches and fellowship with other churches. I think it's very important. But you want to make sure that you stay in a teaching season in your life. You want to stay in a teaching season in your life right now. And it's really how beautiful are the feet of those who preach the good news. But they have not all obeyed the gospel. For Isaiah says, Lord, who has believed what he has heard from us? But look at 17. It says, so faith comes from hearing, and hearing through the word of Christ. So consequently, the foundation to tap into verse 13, which is a great promise, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Well, to tap into 13, it consequently ends this way. It comes from the communication of the message about Jesus. And Jesus is the essence of your hope, the essence of your faith, the essence of your belief. And the more you can understand about Jesus, and the more you can hear clarified teachings about Jesus, you're going to see your faith begin to increase. And so it's a powerful principle there that I want you to see. And so we see back in here, verse 6,